Let's get into NWSL action that is happening this weekend. The Challenge Cup is kicking off on Friday, March 18th, and it's going to have Kansas City Current versus Racing Louisville FC at 7:30 p.m. ET. And a little birdie told me that Lisa Roman's going to be on the call for that one.
I'll be there. Catch me on Paramount Plus this weekend.
that's going to be kicking things off there on Friday. Friday's going to close out with a late night bit of action. We're going to have some NWSL After Dark action early for us, right?
Yeah.
In the month of March. OL Reign versus Portland Thorns are going to be kicking off at 10 p.m. Eastern time. Saturday has a triple header. Orlando Pride versus Washington Spirit. North Carolina Courage versus Gotham FC. Angel City versus San Diego Wave FC. The first two games are both happening at 7 p.m. Eastern time, and Angel City and San Diego Wave are a West Coast battle at 9 p.m. Eastern kickoff. And Sunday is a lone game closing out the opening weekend action with Houston Dash versus Chicago Red Stars at 7 p.m. Eastern Central Standard Time. It's going to be exciting. We've got six matches featuring all 12 clubs getting into their first NWSL competitions.
This is huge, Sandra. This is the biggest or the most number of clubs that women's professional soccer has ever had in the United States. 10 last year for the NWSL, and now 12 adding in San Diego and Angel City. And it's been such anticipation as to watching them play, and not only just seeing them play on the pitch, but seeing them compete against each other. And we get that this weekend, which is fantastic. I think that the schedule is pretty good. It's pretty good considering when you just ran through those, that we get big matchups to start. Yep. OL Reign versus Portland and Angel City versus San Diego. The only thing that I noticed on this one, because the Challenge Cup is broken into regions, East, Central, and West, the East region is playing at the same time. So they're both playing Saturday at 7 p.m., Orlando versus Washington, and then North Carolina versus Gotham, which is fine. It's not a big deal, but that means these teams and these coaches can't watch their other group members at the same time. That's a thing. They watch all these teams. They know how they're doing. You want to see how the other teams are doing, and they won't be able to watch it in real time. Of course, scouting and going back and rewatching tape. But otherwise, it's all pretty spaced out between Friday and Sunday. Six matches. I'm hyped for it.
I'm hyped for it too. There's a lot of little things I think that you can go through in within each of the matches to sort of pick out and say, this is something to look at. But in terms of the general scope, right, of Challenge Cup, we did do an overview of a Challenge Cup preview in terms of the rules, regulation, stuff like that, that you could take a look at how regions are broken down. But in terms of looking ahead into this Challenge Cup, I love this little fun fact here, right? 10 of 12 NWSL coaches are going to be making their Challenge Cup head coaching debut this month. Not necessarily James Clarkson, not necessarily Freya Coombe, who have each participated in the Challenge Cup and quite frankly have both made it to a Challenge Cup final, understand sort of what that means, what that feels like. But that's a good chunk of coaches sort of getting their first run out of the Challenge Cup themselves, right? Along with probably some other players across the league.
Yeah, which I think will provide a different vibe for the Challenge Cup this year, because it's technically a preseason tournament because it is before the regular season. So in the definition sense of it, but it's a tournament that you can win a cup, and that counts as one of the trophies to raise throughout this 2022 year and the 2022 season. So this is a chance for these coaches to kind of establish themselves in this league and in American soccer culture and in professional soccer. We have Amanda Cromwell coming in for Orlando Pride from the collegiate game. We have Kim Bjorkgren coming over from Sweden. He'll be with Racing Louisville. So these coaches that have been shifted around and coming into this, this is new for them. I mean, Laura Harvey, right? She's been here. She's done this before, but not a Challenge Cup. So I'm excited because I think the vibes, it's weird to say the vibes, but like the overall feel of this Challenge Cup will be different because there are 10 coaches that haven't done this before. So they don't know, okay, like what was it like last year? What was it like in the bubble? It's a clean slate starting new. It's a tournament and a chance for a team to win a cup and raise a trophy.
Yeah, I'm in agreement with you on there. I think this is the third edition, right, of this Challenge Cup. And we've already seen it kind of evolve in different ways a little bit. Like, obviously, its inaugural introduction to the league was as this newly inventive thing in light of the height of the pandemic and the first ever of its kind, right? A bubble type of tournament in 2020. And then last year in 2021, becoming this tournament that was still at the latter stage of a preseason ahead of a regular season. So it still sort of had some preseason energy around it, right? With players kind of kicking off some of the long offseason and preseason rust. And then with this year, it still has a similar energy in terms of being this tournament, this type of competition that's happening at the tail end of a preseason, just ahead of a regular season. But now that we've got a 2022 regular schedule that's come out, we also have seen that this Challenge Cup is going to be running concurrent to eventually the regular season when it kicks off on April 29th. So by the time semifinals start getting kicked off, right, for the Challenge Cup, and then boil down to two finalists for the Challenge Cup, there will be a regular season that's already happening, right? So it's interesting for me to sort of take a look at Challenge Cup right now and try to pinpoint what the energy is around it. And I think talking about the fact that there's a ton of new coaches who are going to be getting their first shot at Challenge Cup, combined with kind of this other bit of evolution of Challenge Cup, still sort of being preseason-y, but maybe not, like, maybe for next year's Challenge Cup, we'll start to see it a little different. You know, I know that there's been mixed opinions, right? Mixed opinions, mixed results in terms of the Challenge Cup and what it has become, what it is, and what it could be, right, for NWSL. And as of right now, it is one of three NWSL titles a team can collect throughout a year, right? So you've got a Challenge Cup, you've got the NWSL Shield, and then you've got the NWSL Championship, right? Which has kind of been looked to as the big one, right? In American sports, Super Bowl of women's soccer here. So I'm going to be interested to sort of see how some of these coaches are going to have, you know, the energy around this Challenge Cup, because in prior years, there was absolutely that kind of attitude of like, well, this is a preseason tournament. It's kind of preseason-y. We're going to get to see a lot of different players in a lot of different positions, and we're going to try out some of these new faces and these rookies or these first-time players on our team. And there wasn't a lot of cohesive soccer sometimes that we were watching, you know, come out during those Challenge Cup games, even just last year. So I think maybe this could be a year where there's a little bit of a different perspective with a ton of new blood on the head coaching side of things for NWSL. So I'm excited to maybe see that energy kind of fold out over the course of these next several weeks or so. Let's look ahead to matches this weekend, though, right? Two teams, no longer the new expansion sides. And I guess if you're looking back to last year, this is maybe a bit of a bottom of the table clash. Kansas City Current versus Racing Louisville FC will be kicking things off on Friday, March 18th at 7:30 Eastern Time. Lisa, you mentioned you're going to be on the call for this one. What are going to be some things that you're looking for between these two teams?
Well, so much turnover for both of these squads. I mean, Kansas City has acquired Sam Uys, Lynn Williams. They still have AD French in goal, but with the new head coach in Matt Potter, I want to see what they've been working on over the last few weeks, over the last few months throughout this preseason, because I think there's going to be some magic coming from the Kansas City Current side, just based on formationally and how they set up their organization of their attack. That's what I'm really interested to see. Are they going to go over the top? Are they going to look to keep the ball wide and send crosses in or go down the middle? So I'm really interested to see how that kind of plays out. And for Racing Louisville, about half of their roster is brand new. They only returned 13 players from the 2021 season. They do have Emily Fox, U.S. Women's National Team star defender, is coming up through the ranks. Gemma Bonner in the back line as well. Nadia Nadim is listed on their roster, but she's still recovering from her knee injury. Dr. Nadim, I should say. She's now a doctor. But this is, you know what I'm really going to be watching in this one, Sandra? Jess McDonald for Racing Louisville forward and Lynn Williams for Kansas City Current forward. This is the first time since 2015 that Jess and Lynn will be playing for opposite clubs, and it's happening in the very first match of 2022. They were both on North Carolina Courage since 2015. That's the matchup I'm going to be watching, how their opponents can defend them and handle that kind of matchup. I am going to give this win to Kansas City, though. That's who I've got my money on this one.
Listen, I actually got this one with two goals being scored, right? And I think it's going to be an even match. I think it's going to be a draw in this one. I think that Kansas City is going to have the edge a little bit, obviously, with players that they acquired over the time and, you know, having those players have that familiarity with each other, right? Obviously, if it's a Mewis or a Williams and a Mace and a Hamilton. But I just don't want to look at Louisville and discount what they potentially can have with their own attacking line, right? Getting somebody like a Jess McDonald is huge for them. But, you know, having the return of Ebony Salmon is another. So I'm excited to see both attacks and what they can produce on this day. It's funny to sort of maybe look back last year and say, like, oh, this could be maybe considered, you know, that bottom table clash. But we'll see. Maybe they'll both come out and try to shake that history off of them as well. We're going to take a quick break and be right back to discuss the other regional matches that are going to be taking place over the course of Challenge Cup opening weekend. And we'll take a deep dive right after a quick break.